Hello students, let us discuss the introduction of fluid particle heterogeneous reactions. This is a part of chemical reaction engineering 2, that is a heterogeneous reactions, kinetics of heterogeneous reactions. Myself, Professor M.K. Ahire, assistant professor at KKWAG Institute of Engineering Education and Research. Let us start with the presentation. Now, this chapter is a study of kinetics of fluid particle reactions, where non-catalytic heterogeneous reactions are carried out, where one of the reactant is in gaseous phase and other is in solid phase. Maybe one of the reactant will be in liquid phase also. And that is why gas or liquid, we call it as a fluid, right? So the reaction is fluid particle reaction. That is why. Okay, so this is a schematic of that kind of reactions. A fluid plus B times B solid. This is a stoichiometric view of any reaction where A component is a fluid, B component is a solid, and there is a stoichiometric proportion 1s to B, right? And it is giving a fluid product or solid product or fluid and solid products, right? So this may be the variations in fluid solid reactions, heterogeneous fluid solid reactions. Now this is a simple example of any fluid solid reaction. You can consider a burning of carbon in a coal using oxygen or with the help of oxygen to liberate carbon dioxide and heat is a simple kind of fluid particle reaction or fluid solid reaction. Now this is the treatment of ore. Okay, this is a treatment of ore. Ore is what? It is that soil content which has a lot of metal available in it, which you can economically produce, right? So ores are also require this kind of treatment. Ore is a solid form, but it requires some kind of treatment like carbon monoxide treatment or oxidation treatment or any other kind of reduction treatment like that way. Okay, so this is what one example of fluid solid reaction. So in industries, these fluid solid reactions are commonly encountered, and it is very difficult to analyze the kinetics of these reactions. We have studied homogeneous reactions in CRE1. Compared to that, the kinetics of fluid particle reactions or any heterogeneous reactions is difficult. You have to understand this. Why it is difficult, that you will come later on when you will go more deeper and deeper in this subject. Now, this fluid solid reactions are categorized into two parts. One is the particle size remain unchanged during reactions. Many ores, when they are oxidized or reduced or just baked, okay, sometimes their particle size will remain as it is, but internally there will be some changes taking place, right? So this is what a best view of such a reactions. So second case, in second case you can understand the particle is decreasing size continuously with respect to time. Now sometime if non-volatile components are there, then something will be left over But if non-volatile components are completely not there, then nothing will remain. That you have to understand. It means the particle size either decreases or vanishes during the course of reaction. That is the second category of fluid particle reactions. Many kinetic models have been developed for the progress of the reaction with single solid particles. But only two models are discussed. One is progressive convergence model and other is shrinking unreacted core model. This is called as in short PCM and this is SCM. Now let us discuss more about PCM. Now this model assumes that the reactant gas enter and react throughout the particle at all the time. The rate of reaction is different at different locations. Let me show you diagrammatically. This is the particle, original particle. This is its original concentration of that reactant B, right? Now, as the time progresses and as this reactant B is reacting with A, you can see the particle is occupying more space in the particle is occupied by the reacting components. And hence, this decrease in the concentration takes place. You can see this dome represent initial concentration and there is a decrease in initial concentration of reactant B, that is reactant B, which is solid reactant. We are focusing on it. Progressively, you can see there is more decrease, right? But you can see nearly full particle is covered with the reaction progressively. Okay. So you can understand it very clearly that reaction is taking place anywhere randomly rather than with some pattern, with following some pattern. It is continuously taking, that reaction is continuously taking in a random manner, any space, any part, any section, right? And that is why one cannot use this model to make rate equations of heterogeneous reactions, because what statement we have given? This model assumes that reactant gas enter and react throughout the particle at all the time. Reaction proceed continuously throughout the particle. The rate of reaction is different at different locations. So tell me how you can make a kinetic model, right? If reaction is different at different location, that is my question. Now figure A, I have explained already that how this model works. Now in case shrinking core model, first of all try and understand what is this shrinking core model. In shrinking core model, it is assumed that the exposed surface is first react completely. Exposed surface means you are observing this entire surface is first reacted. This is the flattened line showing that. Okay, flattened dark line showing that this entire surface, external surface, exposed surface is reacting. This sphere is reactant B and over that there is a reactant A surrounding to it. And that reactant A is completely consuming the external part first. That is the assumption. So as time progresses, you can see this thickness is there. This is what the consumed surface, thickness of the consumed surface. And this is unreacted core. Unreacted core means where your reactant A is not approached right now. So you can see this box representing the concentration of the reactant. Okay, its height is same everywhere, but its thickness is changing with respect to the particle, unreacted particle, right? So it means the concentration of unreacting particle is as it is, but its volume is decreasing. It means the unreacted core content is decreasing continuously. It means there is a progress. There is a reaction between A and B. And the reaction is taking place from external surface to internal surface. This is shown by this diagram. And this is what the unreacted shrinking core model. You can see core is first as it is, then it is shrinked. In this way, entire particle has been consumed with the same rate, subjected to one condition, that this newly created material is not providing any resistance to your reactant A, right? So this is what this thickness of this box is getting decreased. The height is same, but thickness is decreasing. It is showing that the effective volume of unreacted particle is decreasing, right? So this is what the shrinking core model is. If you like this video, please share and subscribe. Thank you.